Hi, Christy and Peter. I'm Zach.
And I'm Noah. You have decided to lock our teachers out of the building before and after school and during lunch and break, so you can cut their pay 10% to further bully them into submission. This leaves the administrative faculty with an 80-to-1 ratio of students to adults. What could possibly go wrong with that?
No, that is not a rhetorical question. Allow us to demonstrate exactly what could go wrong with that.
With limited adult supervision, us troublesome youth could get up to all kinds of mischief, like riding bikes in the hallways. Raise a little hell, raise a little hell, raise a little
hell. Raise a little hell, raise a little hell, raise a little hell. Hey Christy, we could even ride unicycles through the hallways. While the few remaining faculty are dealing with the injured unicyclist, who will break up the fist fight downstairs?
Emergency, what would we do? We look to our teachers for that stuff. They're responsible for evacuating us and making sure we are all safe and accounted for. It would be a real shame if teachers couldn't do anything to help us in an emergency if they were, say, locked out of the school.
Side note, yesterday a code yellow was called at our school during third block. Had it happened an hour earlier during lunch, we would have been stuck in the hallways, and even if rooms had been unlocked, we would have had to have taken on all emergency procedures on our own. While we acknowledge that the principal and vice principals are doing their best given the circumstances, there is no way they could have possibly managed 1,200 students on their own.
Christy, Peter, you are accountable for that. To the students of British Columbia, we all place different values on our education, but there's no denying that teachers work their butts off for us.
This whole political drama is happening because the government is making it harder and harder for teachers to teach, increasing class sizes, cutting funding left, right, and center, taking away the limit on special needs students per class. And on top of that, teachers haven't had a significant salary increase in the last 10 years, despite the increased cost of living. So teachers are considerably less well paid than they were 10 years ago. If you want to show your support, there's a rally on Friday, June 6th, and we would love to see you there, standing up for your education and the rights of your educators. Friday, June 6th.
See you there.